Flavio Briatore, thank you so much for speaking to us at Euronews. Take me back to the beginning of your career. Did you always know you wanted to go into business?
Like everybody, you know. After somebody succeeds, somebody not. And I believe every young kid, every young woman, every young man want to be successful.
It was during the 1970s that you met Luciano Benetton.
Yeah.
That was really instrumental and a pivotal moment in your career.
You know, everybody need to have somebody to help. At one point, everything was Benetton. But when you know Luciano was a successful guy, but nobody know how big was it, you know what I mean? And like every time, you meet a lot of people and you have a very few friends. But sure, my life is changing completely.
Now, your F1 career with Benetton and Renault, what was it like back then?
I don't have any intention to be in Formula One. Mm-hmm. I never see a race in my life before. The team was basically supported totally by the Benetton family. Was no sponsor at all. It was a favor, but for me it was just 2-3 months to make these people understand what, talking about commercially, what you need doing, et cetera, et cetera. So the finance of Benetton was much better. And Luciano asked me to continue, to be a commercial director. In the meantime, I fired everybody. The old team, I fired the managing director and everybody next to the managing director. And we start together. We start to finance the team properly. To winning, we need a good driver.
Yeah.
And no driver want to come into us because we are a t-shirt maker. It was, you know, with the name of Ferrari, McLaren, Williams. I mean, to be a t-shirt maker, Benetton, the team was called Benetton, it was kind of funny. But it was not so funny for long because we started to be competitive very quickly. And after in 1992, we found Michael Schumacher, we fighting to have Michael. In 1994, we won the first championship. At this point, we are not the t-shirt maker anymore, but we are the team to be. Michael was somebody very special. Independent of what he's done in the track, was a very special person.
If we head back to 2008, the Singapore Grand Prix, you were accused of match fixing, which you took to court to fight, but you were banned from the sport. If you could go back, would you do things differently?
We go to the civil court. We go to the High Court and we won the case. Mm-hmm. I mean, all this bender was good for 1 month.
Yeah.
Because we even going court because everything was manipulating by, I don't have any problem to tell, by the president of the federation because the guy never liked me from the day one. And there was always against us. It was suspending Schumacher for 4 races and managing the Formula One like it was their own toy, punishing people left and right and crazy, completely mad. And the court of Paris, the High Court of Paris, take away the ban completely, make FIA pay me the money. And for me, it's possible to go back after 1 month. All this stuff for Singapore is coming. We have one driver. This driver had the accident every race. Sometimes I have two accidents in the same race. So if I fix in the race with one driver, why didn't he fire him before the end of the season? Mm. No, if the guy give me so... Plus, we won the race because Massa the pit stop. Barrichello have five driver before us have the mistake. And we are lucky to be there.
You don't want to return to the paddock one day?
No, I'm doing what?
I don't know.
No. If I want to come back, I come back tomorrow morning. I might not want it. Because I was one of the best, you know? Historically, when you talk about the principle of Formula One, the first guy make Formula One different was me. Mm-hmm. And what the people talking? That, people love talking. I won the race for 3 different teams. I want more Monte Carlo, not anybody. Doing what? What I want to do? It'd be ridiculous to go there.
Do you think Lewis Hamilton will potentially equal Schumacher's Grand Prix titles?
The sport has changed. Now the car is much more technical, much more easy to drive, but you need to have the talent. If you put Hamilton in Ferrari, he's doing the same result as Leclerc or Vettel. At the time with Michael, the driver was much more important and because the car was much more equal.
Yeah.
The difference was done by the driver. Mm-hmm. The driver was a gladiator.
Well, it's not just Formula One. You've dabbled with football as well, Queen's Park Rangers, you and your good friend Bernie.
Yeah.
Was it harder than F1?
Yeah, much harder, because in football you have the player, the father, the mother, the manager, the uncle. I think Formula One is much more business orientating, race orientating, performance orientating. But if any choose, I choose Formula One.
You chose to set up several of your business ventures in Dubai.
Yeah.
Why does the city lend itself so well to some of your brands?
Dubai is fantastic. The town and the environment is the big real estate operation in the world. The fact we invest in is because we believe in Dubai. You know, we believe firmly in Dubai. The management of the restaurants are the best. You know, if you see the, we are the best people in Dubai.
So can you tell me about billionaire life and where that fills a gap in the market?
I decided to go back in the food and beverage. And we've done the agreement with Sumo-san in UK, and we start working very well. In the billionaire, we doing the experiment in Dubai. You have a food, you have a show, you have a dinner show. And this was our success key in Dubai, was the dinner show. So we see this concept is working.
COVID-19 has changed the world. Do you think that the F&B industry will bounce back from COVID?
100%. The people want to enjoy entertaining, watching people. It's not life anymore. No, people need meth.
What do you think we can learn from the pandemic globally? Do you think a lot of it's manipulation?
100%.
What do you think is the reason behind it, then?
It's the politics. The people want to stay in the government. We are the worst government, for example, in Italy in our history. It's all propaganda. No one of the minister we have working 1 hour in life. This is our politician. Zero experience. Before, the people at the job in the politics have no job.
Do you think the UK should leave the EU without a deal?
I don't think so, because UK, if you take away the Italian, the Polish, who's doing the job? It was the wrong decision, and I hope UK surviving, because we have business there. But now we need to see the model of the business, if we stay, or we sell, or we go.
You're friends with Donald Trump. Do you think he will be re-elected in November?
Yes, in on a competition.
Friendship aside, do you think he's the right man for the job?
I think so. I mean, we have the record in employment in America. We have the record of Wall Street. I mean, I don't know what the people want more of that. Him is a manager. He's not a politician like me. He's somebody tell you the stuff straight.
Flavio Briatore, thank you so much for talking to us today. Thank you.
Ciao.